I really respect anti-Semitism, specifically this attitude from the nations of the world towards Israel really rattles Israel, shakes Israel. And I really hope that Israel will be able to hear what the Kabbalists are saying, unlike what happened before the previous Holocaust. And I don't think that change depends on the nations of the world. No, they're incapable of it. They also cannot be part of our explanation. They can't understand it. It doesn't go into their ear, much less their heart. Everything we explain, and even though we say that we are to blame, we're the ones who are not doing what we should, and you should help us, even this way, it's as if we're saying to the nations of the world that we're asking them to change their attitude, to be more precise, more directed in a certain direction. And that too won't work. All changes must come from the people of Israel. And our dissemination to the nations of the world, mainly. I'm not saying that what I'm saying now is 100% and that's it. But mainly, our dissemination to the nations of the world should be that they'll be more ready to accept bestowal from Israel, like the goof from the Rosh. But the main thing is the bestowal on Israel, the connection in Israel. That's what we need. Through this connection, to the extent that we'll have this connection, even if it's corporeal, just popular connection without these high thoughts or intentions, to somehow soften and connect the people, and then the upper light affects more, we can talk to the people in a more clear way for them. That's how it will happen. I don't hold any hope in a change in the nations of the world. They're incapable. All the different factions, and in general, from the perspective of creation, they're incapable of it. But all the 2,000 years of exile and the previous exile, all the shattering that's in them, as we learned from the shattering of the vessels, we haven't yet learned the correction of the shattering, how exactly you sort out the kelim out of this mass, which is entirely blown up, and it's all as a pile. So how do the lights awaken these broken parts and correct them with Iburi, Nika, Mochin, and they add them to the Kli? That's something we're going to learn, but it only depends on these lights. They go through the Rosh. They go down through the Rosh, and the Rosh determines the corrections. And the corrections go over people of Israel, which are called the Chab de Rosh, which are connected to Bilgal Te'enayim of the nations of the world. As Baal HaSulam explains in the end of the introduction to the Book of Zohar,